Hello everyone, my name is Arun Kumar and I'm your instructor for the module on setting up two-step or two-factor authentication. The learning objectives in this module are: we will learn about the importance of a two-step verification or a two-factor authentication. We will also learn to set up two-step verification for your own Google account. We will also see how to set up application-specific passwords. We will see how you can access your account if your phone is lost or damaged. So every day, there are tens of thousands of personal accounts that are hacked. Personal information is compromised. Passwords are cracked and lives are put in jeopardy. If you ever use one password for multiple accounts, you are exponentially increasing your vulnerability to being hacked. So why would people suggest two-step verification system? So when you give a password, you are authenticating with the website. When you give your username, you are identifying yourself with the website. It may so happen that the method in which you are giving your password can be hacked. So we need to cater to a second factor, second media, wherein you supply an additional information to complete the process of authentication. So the process of authentication will have two steps. The first step is the password, and the second step will be a special code given to you through a different medium. Have you ever received OTP for your transaction? Maybe for your e-commerce transaction, your online banking transfer, or your social media login. So when it sends you an OTP through SMS, internet becomes one medium, and the SMS is the second medium through which the second factor of verification comes to you. So to pinpoint you and hack you individually, the hacker has to compromise both the mediums of the verification mechanism. So let us see what is a two-step verification system. In a two-step verification system, anytime an unknown device is used to sign into your Google account, the user has to provide a verification code in addition to the password. So it's not enough for hackers to just get your password and get your access to the account. They will also need physical control of your phone or computer to access your account. Let us see the steps by which you can set up your two-step verification and advise others to set up their two-step verification process for a Gmail account, essentially your Google account for all the services connected with Google. So the first thing is you sign into your Gmail account, click on a thumbnail of your avatar on the right side of the top menu bar, click on account to update your settings. After you click on this account settings, you will land on your account settings page. You now have to scroll down until you find a blue bar that says signing in. In the two-step verification section, you'll see if you already have two-step verification turned on, it will say on. Else, if it says off, now we're going to set it up. When you click edit, you'll see a page that briefly walks through the steps of setting up two-step verification. See the image? The blank place where you have to enter your phone. Before you enter your phone, also select the country and enter your phone number. You can also select whether you'd like to receive a text message or a Google voice call with the verification code. When you select that, press submit and then wait for your code to arrive your phone. When you receive the message on your phone, see the verification code, enter in the verify your phone page and press verify. After you verify the page, you move on to the third step where you want to tell Google that I trust this device, I recognize this device. Press OK and you have just set up two-step verification for your Google account. In fact, you can skip any additional steps that seem unfamiliar or confusing for now. We will address all of them in successive sections and modules. of this course. Now that we have understood how to set up a two-factor authentication having your primary mobile number, suppose you want to log in and now you don't have access to your primary mobile number. What will you do then? Google provides us with backup codes. Let us now see how backup codes can be used when you don't have your primary mobile number phone with you. Access the Gmail account. So if you don't have a verification code every 30 days and one day the 30 day period gets over and your primary phone number is not with you, it makes it difficult to access your Gmail account, right? No. In fact, Google gives you backup codes which you can keep with you in your wallet, and these codes can be used when you don't have access to your primary phone, and it can allow you to enter into your Gmail account for that particular duration where you don't have access to your primary phone. Go to your two-step verification settings page. Under how to receive codes, just click on the show backup codes link. It will show you backup codes on the web page. You can either save this page, or the other thing that you can do is you can print this codes and keep it in your wallet or a place where you can have access to quickly when you don't have access to your phone. What if you are accessing your Gmail account on your smartphone? Smartphones have apps, and apps don't require you to access code. These two-step verification work on using Gmail through your computer. To understand the need for application-specific passwords, Google has you covered every time you sign into your account from a web browser. However, if you use your Google account with other applications such as mobile app, those systems cannot ask you for a verification code. Therefore, you will need to sign into those systems once with an application-specific password. You will only need to re-enter an application-specific password if you choose to reset it and generate a new one for that device. So generating an app-based specific password, let us see how you can do that. You can go to your two-step verification settings again and click edit next to two-step verification on the security account settings. There are three steps. You click on the security account settings page, scroll down and click on manage application specific passwords as shown in the image. When you click on these, you will see a list of sites, applications and devices to which you have granted some level of access to your account. If you use other Google applications, you will also see those listed. You can also feel free to revoke access to any site or program you no longer wish to use. So after the list is seen, where you have provided access to different devices, different applications through the two-step verification process for entering the name of a device. Now here specifically you enter the name of the device, which you can remember what this application specific password is for. Example, you're using a Gmail app on iPhone, Gmail app on Android phone, or Outlook on your Android phone, or Outlook on your iPhone. With this, you can generate your password. You should actually generate a new application specific password for each application. So if you have parallel apps running on your smartphone, you should generate a new application specific password. As shown in the image, you have to click on mail on my iPhone and generate the password. For example, if this is the email on your iPhone, open the application, go to the settings page where you enter in your Google account information, type in your usual Google account name. Now instead of your account password, type in the application specific password in the password field. This is after you have generated the password, the application specific password. You now go to the application on your smartphone, go to the settings page, and instead of your account password, type in the application specific password. You have now granted this application full access to your Google account. You will only need to enter this password once. There is no need to write it down or memorize it, and it will not be displayed by Google again. Now click Done on your web browser. Once you have successfully entered the application specific password, this will complete the process. If you don't want to use an app anymore, or you lost your phone and want to stop anyone who has it from accessing your Gmail, simply click on the revoke button in your application specific password settings page as shown in the image. This is all good and fine when you have your computer with you, when you have Google account logged in and you have your smartphone or phone in your hand and you can verify the code that comes to your phone and log into your account. What happens if you lose your phone and it was a two-step verification which was turned on? How can you access your Gmail account? So you can follow the following steps. First of all, the number one step that you have to do is revoke your current application specific password. If you have a smartphone with apps linked to your Google account, they will automatically be signed out. When you get a new phone, you can generate new application specific passwords like we generated in the previous slides. You can go to them and revise the process and enter those application specific passwords to the new devices. Step 2, change your Gmail password. Even if someone else has your verification code, they can't get into your Gmail account without your new password. While it's unlikely that the person who has your phone also has cracked your Gmail password, you can never be too sure. So you must first change your Google password. So if you are logged in to your Google account from any web browser on your mobile device, you will now also automatically be signed out. The third step is you should add a backup phone number if you have a second mobile device. Go to your two-step verification settings page and click add a phone number in the backup phone section. After you do this, even if you don't have a backup phone, use your list of printable backup codes to access your account like we explained it in previous slides. You can go to your two-step verification settings page and show backup codes, and then you can keep it in a safe place with you and use those codes to access your Gmail account if you have lost your phone. If you get phone, change your number. Now that you don't have the previous number, you change your new number. Be sure to revoke the access to your previous number on the two-step verification page. So with this, we have learned how to set up two-step verification process on Google accounts. We also found out the importance of having a two-step verification. We saw how you can generate backup codes when you don't have access to your phone and still want to have access to your Gmail account. We also learned about having application-specific passwords on smartphone because they don't ask you for a verification code. We also saw how you can still access your Gmail account if you have lost or damaged your phone. We also learned if you want to have strangers away from accessing your Google account, you can go to your verification settings page and revoke access from all the devices and apps that you have granted access to your Google account. With this, we come to the end of the module. Happy browsing, and please enable your two-factor authentication. Thank you.